Hey, I'm Cody from Secure Agent Mentor. Do you want to learn how to run a Medicare appointment properly? What should your presentation look like? What steps lead you to closing a sale? This presentation helps you in closing deals and getting prospects to make decisions. That's where we're best at. Medicare sales presentation in four steps. We're going to break this down from the warm-up, the fact find, the presentation, and the close, because they're together, and wrapping up and cooling down. So let's first start with step one. Warming up. I always spend 5, 10, 15, even 20 minutes sometimes building a relationship with the client, getting to know them, asking questions about what do you like to do? What are your favorite hobbies? There's also an old Ford reference that I heard from an old sales manager years ago, F-O-R-D, family, occupation, recreation, and desires. Get to know their family. Learn about what they did before they retired or what they're currently doing. What do they like to do for fun? And what are their desires, their goals? Where do they want to be? When you look around the room, do you see? I'm a big Cowboys fan. Do you see Cowboys pictures on the wall? Do you see, you know, a cowboy hat? Do you see fishing gear? You know, are they on a farm? Are they in the city? You know, how's the weather? Get to know them. Build a relationship with them. If you get to know the prospect, it will be easier to get them to make a decision at the end of the appointment. So I say that step number one is super, super important. And making sure that you get to know them and that they trust you and that they feel like that you actually care about them, that helps later on in the conversation. So step two now is the fact-finding portion. This is where you want to get to know what they have, what they want, what they need, what they can afford, what kind of coverage, what are they looking for this to do for them? What are their goals from this? Some popular questions that I like to ask when I go into a Medicare appointment is, hey, what got you thinking about talking to someone about your Medicare? Was it the plan you have? What you're paying? When's the last time you heard from your agent? And then start to ask them, what's more important? Paying the lowest possible price, having the best possible plan, or making sure that you can get a hold of your agent? Or all three important? Ask questions to get them to talk. That's what this fact-finding portion is about. Section is about getting them to talk, getting them to answer questions, for you to ask open-ended questions so that you can get them to talk about what is going on, what they're looking for, what they need, because a lot of times if you ask questions properly, they will begin to tell you what they want and what they're looking for. So that's why I feel like this is huge in a Medicare sales presentation. Step two, the fact-finding portion, sets up step three, which is presentation and close. In the presentation and close, you want to build the value of you, your company, the product, and what you're selling so that they know that there's value there, which helps them when you get to the close. Because when I'm going over value, I want to get little yeses. I want to get answers to questions. I want to get yeses along the way, these little trial closes that we talk about. I want to go over the benefits of the types of policy that you sell, the benefits of doing business with you, the benefits of the company, and I want to get yes answers to questions along the way. Like for instance, a Medicare supplement plan F is the best Medicare supplement plan. It's the best Medicare plan on the market. Is that important to you? Do you like the thought of having the best and most comprehensive coverage on planet Earth? Is that important to you? Get trial closes. Get questions answered. Once you've gone through the fact find, and then once you get into building value, then you've got to move into the actual presentation where you're presenting the product, you're presenting options, you're presenting the solution from highest to lowest in descending order, from the highest cost to the lowest cost. And the reason is, if you do it in the opposite order, if you do it from lowest to highest, they'll remember the lowest, cheapest option. And when you do it in ascending order, they will always think about the smallest option, and the fact that you're trying to take away, it'll feel like psychologically you're trying to take away the smallest option away from them. But if you do it in descending order and you start with the largest and you focus on value and quality, they will think of it in terms of, oh, that's the one I want. And every one that you give, if you give three options and you do it in descending order, the next two options will feel subpar in their mind to the first option that you laid upon them. And so that's where presenting the right way in the right order and then moving into a close. That's why I always put, in step three, I always put presentation and close together, because I feel like you can't have a proper presentation without a close. Everyone's got a gift. I feel like a gift that I've been given is getting people to make decisions. For instance, if I'm in the middle of an appointment and I want to ask them a question, I want to get answers to the questions that I ask. I told a story on one of our agency calls recently this week and said, hey, I ask people, do you know where your policy is? Well, if they don't know the answer, and there's better ways to word questions, but if they don't know where it is, follow up with another question. I was told by a sales manager years ago, you can ask the same question over and over again as long as you ask it a different way each time. So the second question, after, hey, do you know where your policy is? If they say no, if you knew where it was, where would it be? I'm telling you, it works. It's worked well for me. And so when I get into close, you can do the same thing in the close, which is why I wanted to tell you that story real quick. Because when you get into close and you say, hey, which of these options are you most comfortable with? Which one of these three do you like best if you give three options? Well, they may say, well, I really don't know. Well, if you were going to choose, I always like to put them in a hypothetical state so that I can start to get them to move from I don't know to a yes, closer to making a decision, which is what our goal is from a presentation. And so when I get into the close, I want to get into putting them in hypothetical situations. If you were going to make a decision, if you were going to take advantage of this, if you like this, if it was important to you, which one would you go with? If you had to pick one, which one would you choose? Everyone's going to make a decision. Everyone's going to choose. And so if you start to move them in that direction, you will get them to make decisions and to choose. After you've closed them, then we move into step four. Step four is super important because step four is about long-term, building that relationship, continuing that relationship. What you don't want to do, you don't want to sell a policy and then run out the door. That's something you definitely do not want to do because they're going to feel like, hey, he was just here to sell me. This is why I call step four the wrap-up and even the cool-down because I want to wrap up. Are you happy with your decision? Do you have any questions? Would there be any reason that you wouldn't keep this for the rest of your life? Do you have any referrals for me? Are there other people in your life that you feel like can also need, like also could use help with this? And so this is where I want to concrete things. I want to make sure they saw value in it, make sure they're happy, make sure that the decision was the correct decision, make sure that if there's referrals to be had, that we get those, that if there's a chance to continue that relationship, that it is. And then after I solidify those things, I want to, and I also want to, before I move into cool down, I want to explain the next steps of what's going to happen moving forward. So we've took the application today. I'm going to take it back to the office. We're going to fax it off to the insurance company. They will mail us a policy. I'll bring you the insurance policy, and we will go over the insurance policy, and we'll also let you know the other things that we offer. And so that's another fact-finding opportunity. If you deliver the policy, you don't have to, but if you deliver the policy, that's another opportunity to fact-find, to do my little money bag presentation. If you're a member of our website, we've got our money bag presentation on there. That's what I use to also sell life insurance, long-term care, and annuities to Medicare prospects when I'm face-to-face, in person, in their home with them. After you've done that, and you've explained the next steps of what's going to happen and what's going to happen over the next couple weeks so that they're on the same page as you, when you leave, you don't want them to have questions. You don't want them to think about something and then it kind of bother them. If they're going to ask questions, if something's going to come up, you want it to come up while you're still in the home. So then you move into cool down where you want to come off of business, because if you leave when you're still on business, they may stay on business and ask questions. The spouse, they may ask questions to each other while you're gone. But if you cool down off of business, hey, do you have any exciting plans for the rest of the week? What are you doing this weekend? Do you get to see your grandkids anytime soon? Hey, do you know what the weather's going to be like? Start to cool down. Concrete that relationship so that when you come off of business, it's better, it's easier, and they feel more comfortable that they made the right decision. And also, when you leave, we're off of business because everything was settled while you were there business-wise. If you feel like you got value from this Medicare sales presentation and that you're going to be using my Medicare sales presentation, click subscribe right now. I want you to get notified immediately when we do videos. If you love the content, give us a like. If you want to know more about what we do and how we help agents, go to our website, secureagentmentor.com. Again, I'm Cody from Secure Agent Mentor. I'm here to help you. I appreciate you watching. Click subscribe for me and have a great rest of your day.